Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me in studio today is Peter Eriksen from BioPorto. Peter, it's great to see you.
Thank you very much.
Peter, some updates with your NGAL test to treat acute kidney disease in children. You had a positive meeting with the FDA last week. Tell me a bit about it.
Yeah, I think that one of the key things, we sent an announcement out here a couple of weeks ago where we were saying that we were going to delay the process. But we have had a good interaction with FDA, and I think we have found a pathway forward. It is important to say that if we're looking at the test that we are providing, it's going to be a groundbreaking, a paradigm shift, and therefore, of course, FDA have some questions. But we have had some good dialogue with them and found a pathway forward. So we are relatively optimistic about the future of the clearance.
Before we get to the future, just what kind of questions the FDA have for you?
It is about, of course, we are an early biomarker, and we are talking about how good should the sensitivity be and other things, and are they going to use it since it's an early biomarker? And today they have a slow reacting biomarker, and that is that we need some support also for some of the key children hospitals, and we are in the process of talking with all the key hospitals here in the US. And I do think that so far it's looking very, very good.
You say it's a paradigm shift for the company. How so?
The paradigm shift is that not for the company, but how you're testing NGAL or testing kidney disease. Today, you know, with serum creatinine is a slow-reacting biomarker working after 48 hours. Ours are working after 2 hours. And the key thing here is the whole paradigm, how you're going to treat people afterwards when you get a fast response if you either have kidney disease or not kidney disease. So that's the discussions we are having, among others, with the FDA.
Well, obviously, the U.S. is recognizing this as well, because President Trump did sign an executive order early June to transform kidney care. What was that executive order there, and how does that impact BioPorto?
It was almost too good to be true when we saw it, because he's talking about early diagnostic. And everybody knows in the field that early diagnostic is giving a chance to cure the big damage in the kidney. And with our device, then we are focusing on the early diagnostic testing. And so it's really helping us that we are seeing this. And to understand why it's very important, we have seen in cardiovascular, the BNP and thrombonin have been in. And that have, in fact, changed the curve of the disease. And we still see in kidney disease that it's just going one way, and that's unfortunately up. And I do think that when NGAL finally is going to be cleared, that we are going to be part of the right way of seeing a curve change. So we are conquering the big, enormous problem with kidney failures.
Well, this extended timeline that you now have with the NGAL test, does this impact any other kind of areas of the business?
No, if we're looking at it, a lot of people are, of course, asking us if it have any impact on the adult side. And it doesn't. It's two absolutely separate clinical trials. So it's not going to have any impact. We were in this lucky situation that we had a financial raise in June and July. And that is helping us significantly. So we are seeing from our perspective, it's not going to change anything. It's going to delay us a little, but it's not going to change the whole prospect for BioPorto and NGAL.
You mentioned the capital raise. That's kind of a significant milestone for you. You also brought on Christopher Bird as chief medical officer. He comes from Roche, which is a huge deal, large Swiss-based diagnostics company. I mean, how important was it to bring him on?
It's absolutely one of the key things that we are seeing, we are missing in our leadership is medical skills and medical knowledge. Of course, all of us have been in the business for a long time, and attracting Chris to our team is, of course, significant. That a guy sitting as medical head of medicals in North America and Roche is coming to BioPorto. It's also giving us a stamp of approval when you see very qualified people choosing to join BioPorto.
And what else should investors here in the US kind of look out for Catalyst in the meantime?
I think that the key thing is, of course, looking at that we're going to do the right way and hopefully getting the clearance as fast as possible this year. But the key thing is also that we are trying to upgrade. You will see in our announcement that we are trying to get upgraded our board of directors. We having two Americans up for election here in our August meeting. So I do think that we are upgrading on all fronts. So we are ready when we get the clearance.
Peter, great to have you in. Thanks so much for the update today.
Thank you very much. It has been a pleasure.